Moose are important to New Brunswickers and to our forest, and we're concerned about the moose population due to a winter tick that has devastated the population in New Hampshire and southern Maine. With climate change, it's moving to New Brunswick and it's affecting our moose population. That's why we have partnered with researchers to collect data so we can better understand what's going on with our moose in New Brunswick.
So it's really important that the animal care side is looked after. So that's why they've included a veterinarian on this team, which is fantastic. The animal needs to be given supportive oxygen. While it's under anesthesia, it needs to be monitored for its heart rate, body temperature, respiration rate. Like, all those things are so critical to the animal getting up and running away with that collar on and having, you know, us having no impact on it. This team is fantastic. Irving's basically pulled the best from everywhere. You've got wildlife capture management. I mean, Mike Reed's one of the best helicopter pilots I've ever flown with. Little biased on the net gunner, that's my husband Shane, and he's done quite a few animals. And also we have, you know, some fantastic grad students. We've got Charles, who's doing all the locations and helping with the animal. I mean, really, this whole team effort is essential. I mean, it's important for not just finding the moose, but for quickly handling them, quickly getting them back on their feet and out of there. And you need that team effort, and I'm really impressed with what they have here. So one of the things that I do is look at the body condition of the animal. So I use ultrasound to look at the fat thickness, and that's really important for us to get an overall idea of their body condition. And we're gonna compare that at the beginning of the tick season, at the end of the tick season on these calves. I've worked, you know, all over the world. Basically, I worked in Sri Lanka, Scandinavia, all across Canada. I actually haven't worked in New Brunswick before. I've worked in Quebec. So it's fantastic to get a chance to work here. I'm actually really blown away by how beautiful the forests are here. There's all different stages of forest, and the moose habitat is awesome. So it's kind of neat to see that, to see moose in all these different great habitats for them. And it's just great to see that this project is taking place. I mean, we're all concerned about winter ticks. We're concerned about it all the way up to the Yukon. We have found some winter ticks there. With our climate change, it's definitely changing the life cycle of parasites like ticks, and moose are very susceptible to them. So I'm just super impressed that Irving is taking such an active interest in the moose on their lands and are putting forth so much to make sure that moose survive and are part of this ecosystem.
I'm Linda Warren. I am at the University of New Brunswick studying my Master's of Environmental Management. And I'm out here right now with JDI in the field, working on finding the moose that we had previously collared. And then we're taking some repeat measurements so that we can monitor how they've progressed from the beginning of this project till now. And then we're going to monitor them going forward and hopefully continue this project over the long term.
I'm Delphine Depierre, and I'm a master's student in biology at Université Laval with Dr. Jean-Pierre Tremblay. So we're here to study moose and winter ticks. Right now we are taking blood samples and feces samples. We weigh the moose and we remove the collar.
The data coming from the collars is satellite telemetry, and it's incredible information because we can put these collars on animals and leave them for months at a time, and I can remotely access the material and then plug it into a program called ArcGIS and run a bunch of analyses in order to determine what habitats they're using and where they're frequenting, and that will help us with the continuation of the study.
I'm really happy I'm working in this project because I get to see the moose from closer than I ever had. And you can see all the team working, and it's a great partnership, like with Irving and Michelle Oakley and the capture team, and Charles, the technician, who's wonderful. So it's really nice to work with those people. And yeah, we're having a great time.
The study with JDI has opened so many doors for me personally and for a lot of other projects in New Brunswick. With the satellite data that they have, it will be hopefully available for years to come to expand these studies and provide a baseline for the future. So as the moose population changes and as the weather potentially changes, we can keep an eye on how things are going. So it's really important information.
We appreciate our good partners, Laval, UNB, the province of New Brunswick. We couldn't do this without them. And we're looking forward to what we learn so that we can help the moose here in New Brunswick.